Welcome to the northeastern state of India, Sikkim. Sharing border with Bhutan, Tibet and Nepal, Sikkim is often referred as happy homeland, land of the hidden rice and a big tourist destination. We are here to explore the local food. Come and join me in my food explorations.
On the door, it's a lucky charm when you go out of the house or when you walk in, like they say that see it, so that it's like a lucky charm. So generally it's near the door, like the main entrance of the door.
Looks very similar to jalebi.
Please try
them. What is it?
It is made of rice flour, little bit of normal flour, and some sugar, butter, and milk. Yeah. So this is very similar in taste to the Nepal ka this one, sell roti, but here generally we make it like two rounds and smaller in size. But the taste and I think the texture is same, and you grind it roughly that you get this. Na?
It's very similar to sail roti. The only difference is that in sail roti you have just one circle.
This is also sail roti, but the one which we are in
local style
Nepal
of sail roti.
Yeah, like exactly.
Around Sikkim in style of sail roti.
Yeah, in Darjeeling and Sikkim we have this thing. No. Can you notice something? It's all like mostly green. So it's like the buildings, the public buildings and all, mainly it's like the facade is like green in color, so all shades of green, yeah, it's like that.
So this is the most popular tourist spot, M G Marg.
So till that point, we were in M G Marg, and from this road onwards, this is New Market.
So that market is closed on Saturday and this on Tuesday.
Yes, so this is on Tuesdays, so a little bit difference, but generally it's the same thing, pedestrian only, but this side you have the cars. So this is one of the traditional dresses here, it's called bakku. This is in a modern design, and that one is in the traditional, the Chinese design.
This is the ethnic wear.
Yeah, the bhutias and the lepchas, they wear them. Bread and all, just now the Tibetan bread, wo maida ka banta hai, ya toh aata ka, or bakku. So generally because in the hills, like it's like upper thapar road, you have to keep walking, so they need lots of energy, like carbs. And the other thing is that maida mein, although there is no carbs, and lots of things like thukpa and all made of maida. So basically they need that thing which will fill their stomach and keep going for a long time.
Yeah, it provides
time.
A sustained energy throughout the day.
So that is why like the people here also generally, like they don't tend to like so much vegetables and stuff like that. Like we are more into like either bread based or like meat ka zyada karte. So it's got this creamy, buttery taste,
no? It's an acquired taste. Like I never used to like the salty tea.
Okay.
But over the period of time, I started enjoying it.
Yeah. So generally in the cold climate, no, especially in winter and all, it just keeps your body also warm. And then it's got the butter, right?
Extra fat to keep you warm.
Exactly.
And keep you going.
Yeah. So you can, it's not necessary that you have to drink this only in the morning or the evening. You can have it throughout the day.
Mm-hmm.
And especially the lamas and all, when they are like having the pujas, they have the chants, they keep chanting, right? So their mouth dries up. So we keep on like, you know, refilling their cups with kind of.
So here's our breakfast. This is a sandwich?
This is the Himalayan sandwich.
So when you say Himalayan sandwich, what is so unique about Himalayan in this sandwich?
Okay, the bread especially, it's called phale. It's called Tibetan bread. That is you. And then the things are the same.
Potato wedges and some salad.
So it's a mixture of Himalayan and rich of, the regular
fusion.
So let us see the stuffing.
So the stuffing inside is chicken and I think the
capsicum, onion. So this bread is known as phali.
Yeah,
it's made up of whole wheat flour.
You can make it of whole wheat also, and sometimes we make it of the fine, yeah, maida flour also. So chetli, this is the one.
Yeah. Nice bit yeast.
Yeah.
So that's why it's fluffy.
Yeah.
Mm.
Good?
Nice.
And it's very healthy.
Mm-hmm.
This one is made of meat, so this is not made.
So here we have this bread, phale.
Yeah, this is the phale, but this is plain this time. Mm. And this is generally aloo dum. And this aloo dum is like in the gravy form. And basically the base of this is like dried chilies. This is the gurkhe achar actually around. You can mix some local cheese also, which we call churki here.
Oh yeah, the
cheese.
Yeah, we tried it.
The white one, no? So you can mix that also, you can keep it plain also. And sometimes with this only, again, some people mix kinema, so it becomes kinema chutney. But this
kinema,
is
what is kinema?
Fermented soy.
Bhatmas.
Yeah, bhatmas.
Bhatmas? Yeah. So it is somewhat similar to that naga ka, that akuni. But a little bit lower on the pungency. Akuni is like quite strong. So
aloo dum could be dry or could be gravy?
It could be dry, it could be gravy depending on like how you want it. So since our bread is like plain, so two tippets. You can make it hot or like, mild according to your taste. Generally, I make it very, very hot.
And I was just saying, like, this is very similar to Tabasco.
Yeah, this is like, I can say here, like, this is our version of Tabasco. Because like how they give Tabasco sauce, just to add some extra zing to your food. So this is made of dalle, the local
chili.
Fireball.
The hottest chilies in Sikkim.
In Sikkim and around Darjeeling area also. So this has been made into a sauce. Although in this one, it is not that hot. When you have the fresh ones, it's like more hotter, like you'll get the taste of that. Yeah.
This is nice.
They copied the Tabasco.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. The packaging. Yeah. Is it hot? Yeah, the smell itself makes
What do you call it? Like, it's, you call it hallucination. Like,
Wow.
The base is not the regular, the tomato one. Slightly different.
Yeah.
Slightly different.
You get the taste of that gurkha chutney.
Yeah, yeah. So that is the whole actually idea behind it. And I think this time it's not very hot. Sometimes we make it like really spicy.
Super spicy, depending upon the level of tolerance.
Yeah.
Dummy. Pizza, the sandwich, and the breakfast, chai, everything was dummy.
Yeah, that's the way.
Dummy.
This area is known as Kazi Road, and it's called Kazi Road because earlier, the landlords who are called Qazis, they used to live in this entire area. So that's why it's called the Qazi Road. So now we have reached Dukhi Pan Shop.
Dukhi?
Yeah.
Why is he sad? Why is he dukhi?
We can ask the owner.
Kaisa banate hain pan?
Sada, meetha, zada.
Nahi hai, local wala kaisa khata hai waise.
It is up to your taste and opinion.
Sada pan?
What do you want to
sada, eat? Sada pan.
Sada pan.
Sada pan.
the monastery or the royal chapel. And beyond this point, we have the royal palace, but videography and all is not allowed beyond that point. So the thing is that the name Gangtok itself, it came about being, it means that the hill on the top, which has been flattened out. So basically we are on the top of a hill, right, which has been flattened out, and the palace has been built, the monastery has been built. And there is a stone over there also, which we cannot obviously show, which shows that it started out from this place. So Gangtok town itself started from this place itself.
Okay. The Aloo Chura place.
Yeah, this is started with Aloo Chura. Yeah. As you can see, it is very cramped and he's making for us.
We can sit here.
Yeah, we can sit here. Yeah.
This is Aloo Chura.
Aloo Chura, and it's got aloo,
mutter.
And then some mutter, some local nimki. And this cornflakes is there, and this is called mimi. Okay, just that pink one, just grab one. Mm. It's pre-mixed, okay?
Mama.
So it can be chicken, it can be your veg also.
So it's a very popular street food in Gangtok.
Yeah, this is one of the most popular street food, and it's like loved by everyone in Gangtok. So anyone who goes out, like generally they would want to have like aloo chura. It's a must, yeah. So if you don't want to have it with the aloo, you can make free like that also. Just chatpata
right,
has.
Like a jhal mudi.
This is always packed with students or even office goers. So
it's really good.
So basically, yeah, actually it's a BIHARI dish, but the people from Gangtok, they have like, you know, owned it, and then aloo chura is like from here.
So in Bihar, they eat chura with ghugni. So they will have like, say, this one.
Matar ka.
Or kala chana.
Oh, like all mixed together, ghugni with chura.
Yeah, okay. So it's like ghugni chura they eat. I think he has come up with another variation. He's made it aloo.
Aloo
chura. This is very nice. Like, spicy, salty,
tangy,
crunchy, all different flavors and textures you get into it. Yaar, kahan se hain aap?
Hum Bihar se hain.
Bihar mein kaun sa jagah se?
Motihari jila.
To Motihari mein aloo chura kahan milta hai? Wahan to ghugni chura milta hai.
Wahan milta hai, lekin hum log yahan bechte hain na.
Yahan.
Yahan bahut pehle se pita ji aakar ke yahi kaam shuru kar diye hain. Aur kaam unko kuch lauka nahi. अनपढ़ आदमी लोग का आप झंडे करते हैं, पढ़ा लिखा रहता है तो अपना दिमाग रहता है दूसरे चीज़ पर. वो दोनों राजा के समय में आए थे, उस टाइम में जो पाए वही खोल दिए, अब उसी में हम भी भटक गए. क्या करें.
तो कितना साल हो गया आप लोग को मोतिहारी से आए हुए?
70 साल हो गया. समझिए,
70 साल हो गया यहाँ पे.
जी हाँ, पहले पिताजी था, पहले उनके बाद में हम आए. हम भी बचपने से हैं यहाँ पे.
आपका तो दुकान हो गया ना अभी तो, ये दुकान भी और वो भी तो हो गया.
हाँ,
आपका नाम क्या हुआ?
है?
नाम क्या हुआ आपका?
हमारा नाम नगीना सा है.
नगीना साहब, मोतिहारी जाते हैं?
जी जाते हैं, दशहरे में जाएंगे.
दशहरा में?
हाँ, पूजा वूजा होता है. क्या चीज़ बनी?
I think this is for the delivery.
और यहाँ का भाषा भी बोल लेते हैं?
हाँ, यहाँ का तो बचपन से हम लोग हैं तो भाषा क्यों नहीं
बोलते. चलिए, इसमें लगता है हमको आलू छोड़ा से ज़्यादा जो वाई वाई ऐड करते हैं वो यहाँ का लोकल टेस्ट दे देता है.
हाँ,
है ना?
नहीं देखिए, आलू दम का मतलब होता है आलू दम बनेगा तो आदमी पत्ता चाटेगा, लेकिन जब हम वैसा बनाएंगे तो यहाँ हमारा होना चाहिए ना कमाई. नहीं
जी, जी.
अब उतना हम मेटियल अगर दे करके बनाएंगे, 10 रुपये में बेचेंगे तो हमको तो जमीन बेच करके घर जाना पड़ेगा ना. बात ऐसा है ना.
नहीं, बहुत बढ़िया, लोग पैक करके भी ले जा रहे हैं.
हाँ, ये सब होम डिलीवरी का है, ये सब पार्सल जाता है.
बहुत मज़ा आया नगीना साहब जी, बहुत अच्छा लगा आपसे बात करके, और बहुत खुशी हुई कि आपके पिताजी यहाँ पे आए, इतने साल तक
हमारा
यहाँ पे इन सिक्किम के लोगों को ये जायका दिलाया.
यहाँ पर हम 8 भाई हैं. हाँ, 8 भाई का दुकान है.
आलू चूड़ा का?
जी, आलू चूड़ा का नहीं, कोई माने पान दुकान है, हजाम दुकान है, राशन दुकान है, चना दुकान है.
नगीना साहब जी, आपका आलू चूड़ा बहुत दामी था.
दामी,
दामी था. दामी तो कम, दाम कम था, लेकिन था दामी.
दामी.
So this market is Lal Bazaar?
Yeah, Lal Bazaar na sabji market.
Sabji market.
The ground floor, yeah.
And what are they selling? This cheese?
Yeah. So basically, this is churpi. Made from milk, but different. Yes, this is also churpi. This is churpi. This is cut one. That is also the soft milky one. Okay. So depends on which way do you want it. These are the long skin.
This is a hard
yeah,
cheese.
Yeah, the hard one. So you can cut it up into small pieces like this and then chew it like how people chew supari over a long time, keep it in your mouth, just that this will not harm your health. This is chayakka. So you can buy you can taste one of this, but this is from cow milk. Okay. And those are like yak wala. So you have to take one pura mala. So mala to kati ho? I know mala ko isto.
Ye mala ko 200.
So 200 for the whole one. So no taste, right? Abhi to kuch taste nahi hai. This is from pure cow milk. It's just that it has been dried up and like that. So you just keep it in your mouth only, like that.
Like a bitternut.
Yeah. So it gets softened and slowly the cheese flavor, milk flavor will come out. And this is dalle, the red one and the green one. The Sikkim ka jo actual fireball hai. That time we saw the.
We tried it, the chutney.
So this one. So this is the one.
So these are gundruk.
So this is gundruk. Generally, these are the leaves which are kept under the ground and they are fermented after a long period. So it becomes very sour, khatta. You can make it out of that rice saag, or you can also make it out of this one, what you call radish also.
Honestly, if you smell it, it smells like tobacco.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah,
it
yeah.
It smells like tobacco.
But, yeah.
Very strong.
Yeah. But it's iske
churpi kha raha hai. It's good. Instead of having betel nuts, people chew churpi.
No, you just have to gnaw at it like how a dog will do the bone. So you have to keep at it. This is called chimping. You can have it dried also and fresh also. So this is called chimping. So it's like this, what can I call it? Herb. So in our chutneys we make it, especially with dalle. And one type of tomato is there, tree tomato, no? That wild tomato. So it's very tasty with that.
That's a cucumber.
Yeah, this is the cucumber. The hill cucumbers are very big in size, but they're very crunchy, like under me.
It looks like bottle gourd.
Yeah. So you don't need to peel the, you know, cover.
So you eat with the skin.
Yeah.
These are bamboo shoots, right?
Yeah, these are bamboo shoots. These are the fresh bamboo shoots which has been like put in haldi and boiled for a little while. So you can just mix, just make a stir fry out of it. Soup may be kar sakte. Aap meat, chicken, mein, jo bhi dish mein dal sakte. So nettle soup or nettle, ha. Jo matlab haath mein lagne se it stings, no? Yeah. So uska flower hai ye. This is like an eggplant only when you cut it. But it's very bitter in taste. So we make it like a stir fry. And the gorkhe chutney tha na, usme bhi aap mix kar sakte ho, kha sakte ho isko. This is the churpi, the local cottage
cheese. Is it like chhena ki tarah hota hai?
Haan, almost like that. This will not become like, when you cook it also, it doesn't like stretch out and become gluten. It stays like, you know.
Ghee nikalne ke baad jo pani hota hai, usko pakate hai. Usse churpi banta hai.
Feta cheese.
Yeah, Greek ka jo feta cheese hota hai na, they use it that way. Ha, so that way.
Khatta.
So it's not like cheese as in the sense ki cheesy taste wo nahi aayega. So and this one is fambi, right? This is white color. This is made from that what? Dal ka pani.
Dal starch. Yeah,
yeah, starch. The starch of dal. So like this, you can mix it with some red chutney or
Laughing wala isi se hota hai kya?
It's made, yeah, like almost like that. It's yellow in color. This is just cut into cubes and this one pura block hai.
This is a laughing ban sakta hai?
Haan, ban sakta hai. Sheets banane. So it's the same, like the base ingredients, it's the same.
What is it called?
Laughing bol rahe ho. What?
Fambi.
Fambi. So here, just now it's fambi. Laughing is when you put those other things inside and it becomes laughing that way.
Thank you. So yeah, so this one is like very fluffy, spongy,
soft. And the chicken and all have a thinner wala. So there is no yeast in that too.
It's like very similar, it's very bready, like very, very more of a bread.
Yeah, so this one will be more filling to have. How was your momo experience?
Oh, don't ask me. The worst momos I ever had.
Can you tell us why exactly?
If we found insect in the chicken momo. Like, I always appreciate the food cooked by different restaurants and street vendors. But it's the first time I found an insect, and I can still feel.
Yeah.
I can still feel in my throat that the insect is right here. Yeah. So it was not good. It was not a pleasant experience. Especially the chicken momo. It was quite doughy. I think might be of 1 or 2 days old. They just simply serve it to us.
So the thing is that actually we found not just one,
two.
But twice in two different
pieces.
Right? So obviously not acceptable. Okay, let's take one lemon madeleine. I just like the shape of
the lemon. Okay, one lemon madeleine or one berry cumber.
So the syrup is down here. That's the coffee.
And then that's the cream. Okay. Cream. So you can just. So I guess this berry must be blueberry.
It's blueberry,
blueberry. Yeah.
It's blueberry.
Nice. It's not too sweet also. Yeah, and one thing you notice is that the desserts here, no? Yeah, the even the pastries and all, it's not that overbearing sweetness like kitna sara. You get it, no? So like people, I think they have less sweet.
Yeah.
They like having desserts, but
not too much.
Not too sweet.
This is like good. This is warm, moist, crumbly.
Yeah.
Nice.
That is very crumbly.
And not very sweet also. Yeah.
I can taste egg. That's it. I like this one.
This is good with coffee.
Yeah.
And this is my favorite hazelnut cafe. Mm-hmm. I like this cake. Yeah, the plain homemade cake. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but lemon
there
is very less.
Yeah.
No?
Lemon. You spell the egg.
Egg.
So this is one of the oldest coffee shops in M G Road or Gangtok, the whole of Gangtok. And you get a good view of the mountain. Oh, now it's clear.
Now it's clear.
When we came, it was so foggy. Now we can see the mountains.
So those are just the hills. So beyond the hills, the Kanchenjunga will be seen that side.
So the weather changes here like every few minutes.
Yeah, it's bipolar.
Sometimes when morning it started, it was raining. Then it got foggy.
It looks like the sun might come out.
Yeah.
Karchi Marchi. Yeah, exactly. Karchi Marchi. Thank you. Yeah. So the name of this dish is Karchi Marchi. So this is chicken Karchi Marchi. So the Karchi Marchi itself means the gizzard and the liver of the chicken, which is cooked with some light spices and some fresh like tomato, onions and all that, green chilies. Generally it's dry, but some people like to keep it like little bit watery also, but mm-hmm. here it is served dry, and it's like served mainly like people when they go out to drink or they have friends over. This is served as a starter with the meals.
It looks like you have minced chicken or like minced chicken innards. Like
the innards.
Liver, kidney, chicken pieces, all of that.
Yeah, a few bits of the meat also will be there. Mm-hmm. But generally it's like the liver and the gizzards that is there. So, you can try it.
Wow.
So how is it?
It's quite strong flavors.
Yeah, because of the
liver
and the...
The neck.
Yeah, so the neck and basically the spare parts of the chicken.
Again.
How can.
So this is jhol momo.
Yes. Yeah,
so I think this is like Sikkim style of jhol momo.
Exactly.
Very different from Nepali style. We were in Nepal a couple of weeks back,
yeah.
And there we tried jhol momo. That was a very different texture, very different gravy sauce.
Yeah.
And there it was more of a peanut sesame seeds gravy.
Yeah.
It was served cold.
Okay.
And there it's hot. And it's more of, you can see the tomato pieces, onion,
yeah,
coriander.
And I think the sauce or the gravy is also quite runny and thin here.
Yeah,
right?
Quite runny and, so, and yeah, quite rich. You can see the oil.
Yeah, so. And it's served, the chutney that they serve it with is this one, the peanut one.
Peanut chutney.
Yeah, let's try it. Oh my god, it's so good. How is it?
Wow.
This is
nice.
Yeah.
Now Abby is talking. Yeah. Yeah, come back to the right place.
And the gravy is also quite spicy, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so, yeah. Shall we taste the chutney also? The sesame,
yeah,
chutney,
yeah,
which was there.
Let's do one thing.
Yeah. Isme dale.
Haan, chutney isme dal lete.
So,
wow. It's really good.
So Nimto gets a thumbs up, right?
Yeah. Compared to the other restaurant where we went,
The taste of Tibet.
This one is really better. Yeah. The momos are fresh, the sauce, the gravy is also fresh, it's hot, perfectly cooked. You get the spices, you get the taste of all the spices,
yeah,
all the ingredients, especially Timur and sesame.
Will always overlap because you're in a particular geography, no? So that geography where what is available there is what's going to happen.
Yeah.
So a Nepali home will say make nettle soup in their slight different version compared to a Bhutia home,
yeah,
compared to a Lepcha home, but it'll still be nettle.
Mm-hmm.
Little variations here and there. So we told them like try and be very close to what you normally would produce.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't try the pot stickers. Okay. Have you heard about kothi momos?
I know.
It's very similar to this. Like it's like one side is pan fried, and the other side is like steam.
Yeah.
I think it's the word kothi itself means, I guess, pot sticker.
Yes, yeah.
So it might be derived from the same dish.
It's slightly burnt, right?
Yeah.
And here's the difference. Yeah.
One go.
Yeah.
It's too big.
Yeah.
Oh, you can.
I can.
Let's do it. Let's do it together. Cheers to kimbap.
Cheers to kimbap.
No, you can't do it. You did it.
You did not.
For you.
This was actually homemade bread.
Wow.
That's very good.
Mm.
That's really filling.
Sweet. And buttery.
You will probably find a lack of desserts when you go
around. Yeah, it is a traditional place.
Dessert culture in there, and we are like, let's get the big stuff in, forget about the others.
Yeah, generally people, there's not a like sugar rush.
Thank you, Effie. Thank you for having us. We really enjoyed pot sticker momos, kimbap, bread, lemongrass rice, everything. It was very good. Thank you. So thank you, Abby and Prerna, from our guests. We really had a great time exploring the local food in Gangtok with you, starting from the local cafe breakfast and ending at your home. It was really a great day.
Yeah, me too. We loved hosting you. I hope you had fun today.
Hope you were not scared for all the roads.
No, we were.
Sorry for the road conditions and all.
That's the raw and rustic
Yeah, it is. It is indeed a rustic area to be in.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. It's a cardamom plant.
Mm. So, as you can see,
black cardamom
is actually purple, purplish or reddish in color.
You simply drink it.
It's like the purest form of water you can ever drink.
Refreshing.